you so much for joining. As always, please practice according to your abilities and your comfort level. And just try to find the ideal balance between strength, drive, and effort with softness and surrender. Respect your limitations and not ever going to the place of pain and suffering, anxiety and distress. Think about the offering, the energy, the feelings that you're putting out there, and so that all beings receive all the positive effects of the practice. So on that note, let's begin. Close the eyes. Bring the attention inward. Before God, what existed? Before creation, what existed? God was always there in the midst of it all, and will still be there even beyond the ends of this universe. Merge with that supreme divine consciousness now. Let's begin with the sound of Om three times to attract divine attention. Imagine you are everywhere. Fix your mind on God alone. Beings everywhere, be happy and free from suffering, and enjoy this practice through our senses. May we always have a strong desire for the knowledge that liberates us from pain and suffering. And may we cherish no ill feelings against each other, only peace, love, joy, and compassion. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Do the mantra for purification now. If you know it, you can do it along with me. If not, imagine you're chanting through the voice of the guru and you derive all the benefits of the purification of the space, the grounds, and all the psychic channels within, as though you're chanting it perfectly. Do it. We do it three times. Each time, try doing a single breath, and do it loud enough so it can be heard by all the subtle and gross bodies within and all around us. Om pavitra ha pavitra va sava vashtanga topi va yaha smarit pandrikaksham sabahya bihantra ha sajihi. Om pavitra ha pavitra va sava vashtanga topi va yaha smarit pandrikaksham sabahya bihantra ha sajihi. Om pavitra ha pavitra va sava vashtanga topi va yaha smarit pandrikaksham sabahya bihantra ha sajihi. Do calming breathing now. This is a good technique to bring the mind into a state of calm, free of cravings. Cravings, of course, lead to attachments, or could lead to attachments, which ultimately lead to suffering. So this helps to prepare the mind also for meditation. When the mind is content, the mind that it has more of a tendency and inclination to be capable of holding the concentration longer. Meditation being in uninterrupted concentration. Left hand in Yana Mudra, second finger and thumb connected, other three fingers extended on the left knee. Right hand, second and third fingers fold down towards the palm. This is Vishnu Mudra, turn the palm towards you, then becomes a mudra that we use for pranayama. The right thumb for the right nostril, right ring finger for the left nostril. So try to keep your fingers close to the nose. So I demonstrate a little bit, I open up a little bit so you can see, but for your own practice, keep your fingers close to the nose. No breath retention, just an inflow and outflow of breath. But you hold the nose, both nostrils closed between the inhales and the exhales completely before you exhale. Just hold it for a second before you start the next cycle of either the inhale or exhale. Sit up very tall and straight. Keep the attention as much as possible to the space between your eyebrows. And then on the inhale, imagine the breath moving down. On the exhale, imagine the breath moving up. This keeps your mind focused on the exercise. So let's begin. Sitting up tall and straight. Exhale, completely empty the lungs. Then close off the right side. Inhale through the left. Imagine the breath moving down. Close left, open right, exhale, back up. Inhale down to the right. Close right, open left, exhale, back up. Back down to the left immediately. Fill up the chest, but the breath moves down. Close off the left side, open the right, exhale completely, push all the air out of the lungs by the end of the exhale. Inhale, fill up again as much as you can. Inflate the lungs, raise the chest. Close the right, open left, exhale back up. Inhale down, keep watching the movement of the breath. Close left, open right, exhale. Back down, inhale through the right. Close the right, open left, exhale. Nice, smooth movement of breath, no discontinuities. Inhale down, left. No breaks in the flow. Close left, open right, exhale. Back down through the right, inhale. Close the right side, open left, exhale. In left. Out right. light exhale up, down right, up left. In left, down, up through the right, down through the right, up through the left. Continue a few circles on your own. If you have more lung capacity, you can increase. You can lengthen by just slowing down the count, the inhales and exhales. Keep visualizing this movement of the breath, watch it in the big screen sitting inside your forehead, just between the eyebrows. Imagine that. See, perceive yourself doing exercise through that. If your mind starts to stray, just pull it back whenever or how often you need to. Be unconcerned as to the frequency of how often you lose your attention. Keep up the effort. Keep the temperament the same, unchanging, unconcerned, unjudging. On the exhale out of your left side, conclude, take your time. Once you're done, take the right hand and also in Yana Mudra on the knees, sit tall and supreme. Through the practice, you learn to become receptive to all experiences. And when we cling too much to a certain idea, a certain way of doing things, we prevent ourselves from embracing all and all from every experience and from all beings, all perspectives. They're all important. We have to experience everything. Now through the practice, we'll try to bring that into light, put that into practice by imitating all the forms. And no matter what form you're in, try to see the divine qualities in each and every one. They're all divine reflections of God's magnificence and grace and beauty. Now, let's practice. Come to standing. So we'll start off by some exercise to prepare the body for the practice. Start to swing from one side to the next. Bow the arms, slap the body, make heavy ropes. From here, shake the shoulders faster. Feel as though the arms are dead. The head to slide all the directions. And then start to slow it down. Hands on the hips. Continue. Make large circles with the head, the ears, touching. the shoulders, the chin on the chest, the back of the head sweeps across the top of the back. And then change the direction of rotation. Try to keep your eye on the floor, no matter where the head is in its rotation, including all the way back behind you. Now the right arm circles forward. Feel so you're holding weight of 5 pounds in your hands. And then go backwards, winding up like you're about to throw a ball. Left arm now, forward. And then go backwards. Here. Now take hold of the opposite elbows over the head and then bend to your left. Go to the right now, push the hips out towards the left. Try not to make fold in the underside of the body at the waist. And go to the other side. And then one more time to the left. And go to the right. And then coming back up. Going now from here, little circles over the head, like just moving the head, neck, and shoulders mostly. And then start to make the circles a little bit bigger with the chest and the upper back coming into the movement. Starting to feel a pull in your waist area. And then start to make, if you feel comfortable, full circles. Sweeping the arms across the tops of the feet. And come all the way up. And then opposite direction. Starting off the little circles again. Head, neck, and shoulders mostly moving. And then start to bring the chest and the upper back into the movement as well. And finally, if you feel apt to do so, the whole torso swings down. Back up, release, shake out the hands, move the fingers very, very rapidly. Again, no control over the hands, they're moving all by themselves. And then up and down. Arms up to the side, swing the right leg back and forth. If you like, come to a wall, bring your left hand up to the wall. Loosen up hip. And then the other leg, try to get the knee right to the shoulder, lean forward a little bit, as your leg's coming up. Imagine you're just trying to kick your head, soften the head from behind as well, and the leg goes back. And then release. Now bring your feet together, your head down, your head down to your chin's on the chest. On the inhale, we're going to start to lift up. So inhale, come up, lift the arms, lift up off the heels, 2, 3. Exhale, down, 2, 3. Slowly lower the heels and comes back down. Inhale, feel the arms floating up by themselves. Keep inhaling, rise up off your heels, come up tall. Exhale, down, 2, 3. Pushing through with your toes, engage the leg muscles and the core so you come down with control. Up, 2, 3. Rise up, 2, 3. And down, 2, 3. Continue, go down. Head back down. One more time. Inhale up. Float the arms all the way up. Feel yourself lengthening. And come down, 2, 3, and all the way down. The chin back onto the chest, gesture of humbleness. Remain in that mindset throughout the practice, offer of the practice. Imagine this as your divine duty to all beings everywhere. Now come to the front of the mat, Surya Namaskar. Hands up from the heart, I'm going to renounce practice makes it even better than meditation makes better than practice. So let's move together as one to stay in that collective intention, that collective mind of offering. Raise your arms up, bone head, arch back, fold down, chest on the side, bend your knees if you need to, bring your hands flat on the ground. Right foot back, lower down the knees, sink down to the seat. Push the seat in, bring the head up and back. Come into high plank. Lower down the knees, the seat all the way back behind the heels. Now glide forward between the arms. Tuck at the floor as you're trying to pull the floor towards you to propel yourself forward with more power in the knees. Come all the way back. Modify as you need to. Move according to your condition. Remember, come forward into your cobra. Arch the back. Try not to lose your neck. Keep your telescoping neck out of the shoulders. One more time. Come forward. Glide between your arms. Raise the upper body up, head over the seat. Now roll over your toes back into Adho Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog. Look to the hands or right foot forward. If you can't get to sit there easily, lower the back knee down. You can use your hand also to slide your foot forward between the hands. And then bring the feet back together, chest on the thighs, head down. Come right up to standing, reach up over the head. Hands back to the heart. Go up the back, engage the buttocks in the upper back to support you in your back bends. And then come forward into Uttanasana. Left foot back, drop down the knees, sit down through the hips, into the plank. Then down with the knees, the seat all the way back again. Come forward into your cobra. Roll the shoulders back. Uncoil. Come all the way back. Imagine your snake creeping through the grass. Brush your nose to the ground. Come up gracefully. One more time. The seat all the way back. Keep the spine long. Try not to crunch your lower back or the back of the neck. Stay long. Move in a way that doesn't create any kinks in your lower back or the back of the neck. Back into Adho Mukha Svanasana. Melt the heart. Left foot forward again, making modifications as you need to bring your foot between your hands, and then bring the feet back together. Pull the body down onto your legs. Fold the body in half. Come right up. Reach up over the head. Pranavasana, always coming back to the source of divine body. Raise your arms up. Every moment reflecting surrender, devotion, divine love. The head comes down. Right foot back, lower down the knees, sit down to the seat. Into the plank. Lower down the knees, the seat all the way back. This time, as your hips go to your hands, lift your hips and your knees up off the ground. Upward facing dog. Right back into downward facing dog. Allow the heart to melt. Soften line of the back body. Right foot steps forward, back knee down. And then Uttanasana, feet together, body against the legs. Come right up to standing. And then back home, hands to the heart. Again, all the moves done powerfully, gracefully. Bury your mind deep in the heart. Watch the body move even more power, grace, and ease. Left foot back, lower down the knee. Into the plank. Down we go, the knees, the seat all the way back. And then come forward. Swing up your hips and your knees up off the ground and your hips come between your hands. Adho Mukha Svanasana. Of course, move according to your condition. If you want to skip with cobra, that's more to your level. That's all good. Left foot forward. And then feet together. Uttanasana. Come up. Hands back to the heart. Different variation. Raise your arms up. Go forward and down. Right foot back. This time, keep the back knee lifted. Stay strong for the back leg. Into the plank. Bring the seat all the way back. This time, if you can, right into upward facing dog. Pull your elbows right to the sides of the body. Push in towards your toes and into hands to help you. And back into Adho Mukha Svanasana. Melt the heart. Right foot forward. Back leg stays strong. Back knee lifted. And then send the left foot in to meet the right. Uttanasana. Come right to standing. Arch back. Return home. Again. Go up and back. Go forward and down. Uttanasana. Left foot back. Remember, the left knee stays up. And into plank. If you'd rather go into Chaturanga instead of all the way back, you can. And then into upward facing dog from here.
or according to your condition, move the body just in a way that allows you to find your comfortable edge. Bring the seat up or back. But if you're willing to challenge yourself, Bhavani stays lifted. Just try to go to the edge of your potential always in a wiser way. Uttanasana. Come up to standing. Hands up to the heart. Another form. Raise your arms up. Go forward and down. Lift the hand to chest. Hold your breath. Press up your hands. Jump or walk back. Bend your elbows into coming down so you land softly, not with a big heavy jarring movement. Into upward facing dog here. Now bend your toes under. Move your hips a little bit further between your hands. And then pulse. Try to get your chest up, your nose up. Make like a dog howling at the moon. Again, really push down in your hands. Try to keep the back body long. No big wrinkles across the lower back and the back of the neck. Now push into your hands. Lift your seat. And then back into downward facing dog. Here, you just try to soften the line of the back again. Try to not bend your arms. If you have the flexibility, bring your belly towards your thighs. Tap your top hand to the ground. If you're more flexible, maybe your nose comes down. Maybe even your chin. Be like a dog, stretching its back. Again, demonstrating loyal to the dog, to its master. Embrace all of its qualities. Now lift the heels, lift between the hands, bring your feet forward, hopping or walking. Hold your breath as you jump forward, so you land lightly. Pull the body down onto your legs, come right up to standing, arch back, and then come back home. Again, raise your arms up, stretch, and fold down. Lift the head and chest again, press into your hands. Back into chaturanga, softly. Any which way, hopping or walking, into upward facing dog. This time, transition to two forms. So round your back, so you're making your way back, and then drop your heart down towards the ground. Immediately start the next cycle. You can even just do one cycle of transition to upward facing, and then back the other way. Round your back, and sink your heart. One more. Imagine as you're coming forward, you're trying to push your heart right between your shoulder blades. Then coil, push your chest, your heart right to the center of the chest, back the other way now. Back up through between your shoulder blades, and finally down, the heart pressing towards the ground. Now lift the heels, bend the knees, lift to the hands. Again, bring your feet forward, hopping or walking. Pull the body down onto your legs. Come right into standing, reach up overhead. Back. And then come back home. Hands to the heart. Good. Now take a deep breath in from the heart up to the space between the eyebrows. Hold the attention there at the space between the eyebrows. Imagine that all the love you sent up there is now being sent to all beings everywhere. Share whatever you have. Exhale back down to the heart. Remain established in your spiritual heart where God resides. And release. And now let's just keep on imagining that in every form you stay established in that spiritual heart of all beings. Starting off with your left, on your left foot, ballet pose. Bring the right knee up, take hold of the heel, and then bring the foot out to the side. Flex the foot, and then try to have your fingers and toes on the same line. If you're more flexible, bring the foot higher. It may look more like a letter Y. And then lean back if you like. If you're having trouble balancing, you can stand against a wall. If you can't get your legs straight, you can hold underneath the knee. And then from here, bring the foot in front. Bring your hand to the hip, and from here, if you can, take hold of the big toe. So bend your knee if you need to. Push the foot out. Press through the base of the toe and lean back a little bit if you can. Push your chest up. If you're having trouble with that, take hold of the shin and just push it into your shoulder. And then if you can, if you're comfortable, you can lean back a little bit. So again, do use your creativity to just find the
pose that's suitable for your level. It feels like an offering, your best offering. And then come back down, bring the foot down. Try it on the other side now. On the right foot, step firmly down, take your left knee up, take hold of the inside heel if you can. Into ballet pose, try to embody all the poise and the grace of a ballet dancer. Offer up every posture, divine expression of love. Now from here, bend your knee, take hold of the big toe. Circle your index fingers and your third finger and your thumb around the big toe. Lean back, bend your right knee a little bit. Push your chest up, or again, just take hold of your shin. Pull it up and towards your shoulder, the knee. And then if you feel comfortable, you can lean back. Imagine you're almost trying to lie on your back. And then break, come back down. So try another sequence here. Move to the back end of the mat. Fly your arms out to the side. Bring your left foot forward. Bend your left leg so you can bring your belly onto your thigh. And then swing the right leg up. If you're having trouble bouncing, just bring your index fingers to the ground. And then raise your head a little bit. Try to arch your back. Try to get your foot higher than the head. The head's about the height of the knee. Feel like an eagle swooping down from a great height. Now from here, press into your left foot, come up. Take your knee up as high as you can and point your leg across the standing leg. Turn to your left a little bit, point your toe. You might be able to hook your foot around the back leg. If not, just keep it there, hanging out to the side. Left arm over the right. Garudasana. So imagine you're coming back, just resting. Try not to lean forward too much, your shoulders, side now. Into the back end of the mat. Move your right foot forward. Bend down. Arms out to the side. The belly on the thigh. Raise the left leg up. Point the toes. Imagine you're soaring in the air, skimming the surface of the ocean. You have to imagine you're the eagle. Put yourself in its body. Your right foot, hold your breath, come up. Bring your knee up as high as you can so that when you wrap it around, your thigh comes higher up on your standing leg, and then you might be able to hook more easily. Point the toe, turn a little bit to the right, and you may be able to get your foot to find its way to wrap. The right arm over the left and sit. Imagine yourself playing with the image in your mind. So one more. Bring your left. Oh, good. Just face your chin. So you turn your left. Bring your left foot forward. Bend down. Bring your left hand to the ground, about 14 to 16 inches. Ardhasana. Raise your right leg up. If you have trouble, you can lower down on your left knee. If you can't reach the ground, if you don't have a block close by, just come down onto your left knee. Open up. Try to look up. Shoulders and hips on top of one another. If you want, you can bend your knee, take hold of the foot. You can soften your left knee as you're taking the foot. It might make it a little bit easier. Then when you push your foot up and back, then you can straighten out your leg. Stretch the whole front of the body. More advanced, you can look forward. Make sure the left hip is over the left heel. Hold your breath, take your left hand up to the chest, or if you like, pull the heel in towards the seat again. Take the foot, both hands, and push the foot up.
people pose. Break the pose. Right foot comes back in, bend your left knee, and send the right foot back down. Try it on the other side now. Move the right foot forward, bend your knee, bring your right hand, not too close. Give yourself distance, a little bit of distance, more than a foot, at least 14 inches or so, 14 to 16 inches, maybe more depending on your height. And then raise the left leg up. Make sure you're pointing the toe to make it pretty. Again, lower down on the right knee if you need to. Pull your left leg up as high as you can. Good. And then from here, if you like, bend your knee. Take hold of the foot, bend your right knee at the same time. Push into your finger pads. And then start to push the foot away from your body. And then you can straighten out the standing leg. Try to get your knee to point up. That's it. Stretch the whole front of the body. If you want, you can look forward. Try to center your hip over the heel. Hold your breath. Lift your head a little bit. Bring your heart, hand to the heart. If you want to go further, take your foot in close to the seat so you can take the foot more easily. And really push the instep into the ankle into your hand. So now let's come to the middle of the mat, facing the long edge of the mat. We're going to go to left first. So place yourself so you turn your left foot forward, you're facing the camera, you can still see the screen. Jump your feet apart and turn to your left. Bend your left knee as much as you need to get your knee over the toes and your seat down. Eventually, if you bring your right hand down, you may be able to touch the ground. Reach forward, come forward with a sense of angry determination. Embody that determination and perseverance in your practice. Raise your right arm up to meet the left. Virabhadrasana 1. If your right hip can't turn all the way forward, you can see if you can lift the back heel. If it's too much, you can lower the knee on the ground. Bow up, pull your body up out of the hips. Express that great devotion that warriors have towards the people that they protect. Now lower the knee down. From here, hands and together, index fingers together, rock your shoulders back, Kapalasana, pull the arms back. Make sure your arms aren't bent. Think of the shape of a crescent moon and just try to realize the shape that you see in your mind. Eventually, may your index fingers go to the back toe. Inhale, come back up. From here, turn to your left, the right. Left hand to your knee, right hand slides towards the back knee. If you can't reach your foot, you can take your hand to your, just the back of the leg, close to the knee. If you're more flexible, you can take the right foot up. And if you know how to do, you can either, if you can't get your foot all the way up, you can just bring it in your hand or press the foot to the inside of the wrist. Arm out like this. If you can take a full bind, pull the heel, foot close to the shoulder, lean towards the foot. I'd like to lock my fingers in front of the chest and then lift your wrists and pull your arms to the other side of the head. And then push your foot away from the shoulder. Again, this is just an option for more advanced practitioners. And then release. From here, we're going to turn to the front. Move your left foot to the edge of the mat. And then slide your right toes back. So you can roll to the right, so you can get your hip to come right down, right forearm. If your hips are tight and you can't get your hip anywhere near the ground, stay on your hands. But just see if you can just continue to sink your hip down. Imagine they're made of the hip bones are made of lead. If you're on the forearms, keep telescoping your chest forward. when the hips are anchored down, you might be able to, the rest of the body might follow more easily. Keep lengthening. The more you lengthen the body, comes closer to the ground. You're very close to the ground. You can bring your arms the outside of the foot. Give yourself more space. Shoulder comes down onto the knee, onto the foot. Telescope your chest forward. If you're very flexible, you're on the flat on the ground, you can take your left arm over your foot, underneath the knee from the right side. Join your hands over the back. Make sure your knee stays close to your shoulder. Make sure it's not popping out. Move your foot out so that the knee is on top of the heel in the same line. Break the pose. Come back up. Good. Turn this way so you can see. And then from here, lift the toes up. Adho Hanuman Asana. Your hip is over the back knee. And sink your body down onto your front leg. Maybe your shoulder will come right beside your knee. Maybe your forearms come right down. Imagine you're trying to touch the top of the head to the front of the foot. Keep moving your chest forward. Now, if this is already quite at your limit, you stay there. Otherwise, lift your head and again. Sink your seat forward. Bend the toes under your back foot. And then slide your left foot out a little bit more. Helps to have it off the mat, actually. So straight line from the back knee to the front knee. And pulse softly. Don't overstretch. Be mindful in all your exercises so you don't go to a place again of pain or suffering. And then, if you can get all the way down, you can bring your hands up over the head, maybe cross your wrists. This process, anything is possible. Have the sheer determination and faith that Hanuman had to accomplish great feats. Be fearless. And from here, break the pulse. From here, if you want to try to transition into Vasisthasana, there's a couple you can consider. If you're in splits, you're quite flexible and you have the strength, you can take hold again of the big toes, your two-piece fingers and your thumb, drag it back. I'm going to use my mat in a second. And then, so you can pull the foot all the way up. If that's too much, you bring the foot back. You can stay on your right knee even. And then stay here. Or if you can, press into your hands and bring the right foot in behind the left. Push your hips forward. Vasisthasana. You want to raise the left leg up. Now if you have the left leg up, keep it up. Turn back to plank. Or downward facing dog, depending where you are. Left leg all the way up. And send the foot between your hands. If you have strength, you keep the knee up. Raise the right arm up. And go to your left. Padavita Paschalkanasana. So your left hand pushes down to right, the belly comes higher than the thigh. And then keep rolling the back towards your left. Try to keep the center chest moving towards the thumb if you can. If it's too much, do it off with your knee up off the ground. You can take the knee down first. If you know how to take a bind, you can bring the seat back. Use the left hand to guide the right arm underneath. Create more space to the foot of the seat so you have more distance for the hands to slide under. Left arm goes over the back, pull the head out from underneath. And then you can lock your fingers together, hold the left wrist, pull the left shoulder all the way back. The more you practice, the more you gain these tricks to get into the poses efficiently. And you can take the knee up off the ground, hold your breath, do everything with slowly so that you're in control. No rush, no jerky movements, no aggressive. here, break the pulse. Bring hands back to the inside of the left foot. Circle around, face the long edge of the mat. Arms out and come up. Pull to the other side now. Turn around 180 degrees if you need to, if you can't see the screen again. Sit down deep into the hips. Come forward. Look like the warrior, ready for battle. Embody all their characteristics, the strength, the power, the courage, and then, of course, the devotion. Turn forward, virabhadrasana. The pose says, take me, grant me higher devotion. Lower the back knee down, flatten out the toes, kapyasana. Back. Arms straight close to the ears so that you find that nice form of the crescent moon. Eventually toes going over the back, the fingers going over the back toes. And then come back up. Right hand to the knee. Left hand either just to the back of the thigh, close to the knee, or slide it back towards the foot if you can. Lean away from the front leg, curve your body, try not to make any wrinkles in your waist area. And then if you want to go further, you can try to come into your swan. Take the foot up. If you can't get it very high, you can take it in your wrist or rest it in just the foot against the inside of the wrist. Right arm forward and up, it's a beautiful form here. Or lean towards the foot, take the foot close to the shoulder, and then lock the fingers together, lift your wrist, so the arm comes up, and then push your foot away from your shoulder. Think of a swan's neck, you don't want to have a big, there's no big kinks, no sharp bends in the neck. Pull the foot close to your wrist shoulder first before letting it go so it doesn't come crashing down. Turn to your the front again. The right foot moves out to the long edge of the mat. Scooch the left foot back. This will help you to get your hip a little closer to the ground to start with. And then fall to your left. If you can, come onto the forearm, go to the right. Yes, on your hands, think of cobra pose or sphinx. With your hips anchored down, imagine you have a big weight sitting on top of the seat. Maybe that heaviness will spread to the front part of the body. So make sure that the knees not fall away from the shoulders. So make sure this is not happening, or this. So you want to have both sides of the hips, the seat down. Move your foot out as much as you need to. Keep your knee over your foot so that your knee stays close to the shoulder. Eventually, your body's lower than the leg. High enough again if you want. If you're flat on the ground, your shoulder is on the foot, right shoulder. You bring your arm over the foot from the outside, underneath the knee, over your back, and then join your hands together. Be like a lizard just warming itself on the earth. Imagine yourself in the form, tap into its consciousness, you will eventually find your ease. Now break the pose, come back onto your hands, ready for Adho Hasana. Turn this way so you can see, and then bring your chest down, your belly down on your thigh. Imagine trying to move your chest beyond your knee. Take your attention to where you feel tension or tightness, restriction. Send an intention of releasing there. That's where the prana will go. And help you to achieve that result. Now stay here if this is already quite at your edge, or bring your seat forward and then start to slide your left, your push through the base of the left toes. And slide your right foot forward. Try to keep your shoulders over the hips So move your hands beside your hips, come onto your fingertips. If you need to, you can place a block underneath your thigh and just keep pressing evenly with both feet so that one hip doesn't go way in front of the other, in this case, the front, the right hip. And if you're flat down, you can take other variations as you know them. Pull body up by the hips. You become what you believe. So all these forms of body, all these beautiful characteristics, they're all within you already. Just need to turn them on. And then release, coming into Vasisthasana. So if you want to try that entry, if you have the flexibility, the strength, bend the toes under and back foot. Left hand, you're pushing into the heel of palm. Drag the right foot back through the breath, spin on your foot, and then just push your hip up. And then you might be able to come to this form, or again, if that's not doable, just scoot your left knee in underneath the left hip. Come into your modified side plank. And then if you want, lift your hip off the ground. Bring your knee up off the ground. Make sure you're not sagging here and you don't drop through the shoulder. Keep your left arm fully extended so you stay stronger for longer. And from here, come back to downward facing dog, raise your right leg up, nice and high, and send the foot between your hands. From here, out of Vita Pashkanasana. If you do it without dropping your knee to the ground, then go ahead. Otherwise, bring your knee to the ground, start your ascent. So from this pose, make sure you're not just stuck somewhere here with your hands at the shoulders, your body is trapped by the leg. You have to push the top hand down to the bottom. Form a fist if you like to help you to raise the belly up over the thigh. And then roll the right shoulder all the way back. Pull the right hip back, the head forward to lengthen the spine before you spin more. And again, if you want to take your bind, push your seat back, giving more room for your left arm to snake underneath. Assist with your right hand. And then take your left hand, your right hand over your back. Lock the fingers together or hold the right wrist with your left hand. Make sure you're not sagging like this. Keep strong for the back leg. Push up through the heel. Spin your chest and face upwards. Good. Now from here, release. Bring your hands back to the inside foot and face them over. And then come to the center. Now from here, Prasna Vita Parottanasana is right here. So your feet are parallel. You can take hold your shins, outside legs, lower legs, or if you can't, step on your fingers with your outside edges of your feet. Pull head out and pull head right in between your feet if you can. You can get your head down to the ground. Great. If not, it's still great. It's all perfect if you're just trying your best. If you have more flexibility, so you can get your back and the head to come in line with the heels, your chest to end up behind your legs. Roll the thighs outwards, roll the shins inwards. Here you can do an inversion. You can either do a headstand, or you can do a forearm balance or a handstand if you like. So if you like, if you have a headstand, your fingers move behind your heels, your top of the head's down, and then see if you can strap your legs right up. Okay. If you can't get yours come up in a straddle due to hip limitations, you can walk your feet behind your hands. Press just underneath the knees against your elbows and then flick your toes away from the ground. You can stay here. Nice and steady pose. If you want, bring your knees up, your feet up, and then you can do your regular headstand. Not staying long here. just practicing transitions and keeping the mind quiet through all the transitions, unaffected, unchanged, undisturbed. Now we're going to come back down. If you're straddling down, make sure that you're engaging core more as your feet come closer, so you can land your feet lightly, exactly where they started from. And from here, let's do this. Move your hands out in front. Lower down if you can on the forearms, or if you can, just kind of flexibly slide your feet out. As far as you can, be mindful of this. Very flexibly, you might be able to come all the way down. Like so, and then you can come on the forearms or flat on your belly, depending on flexibility, if this is too much. From here, you walk your hands forward, more like you're in a plank, and lower your knees down. And then heels can be either in line with your knees, it's a little bit more intense, or if it's too much, you bring your big toes together. And then just try to drop your seat down. Okay, so lots of different options here. If you're more flexible, if you're doing a frog, try to bring your seat back in line with your heels. Otherwise, just try to bring your pelvis down between your knees. Whatever form you're in, remain unchanged in the mind. Temperament stays calm. Being witness to all of it helps watching yourself as though you're watching from outside of yourself. Rest into your hands, lift back up, move one knee in at a time, nice and slow so you don't overstretch, and then come back. Now, arms up to the side, come all the way up. Turn your toes out, your heels in, easy Trikonasana. If you're more flexible, you can move your feet a little bit closer. Bring your hands to your seat, push into the seat, pull down. And then when you feel comfortable, keep curling the tail down and under. So you're trying to pull the seat all the way down and under towards the backs of the knees. When you feel comfortable, you can allow the head to drop back slowly. And if you want, you can slide your hands down the backs of the legs. The hands can come right underneath the knees, just below the knees. The thumbs come further in between your legs as you roll the thighs outwards, roll the shins inwards. So roll the thighs outwards, roll the shins inwards. More flexible, you can slide your hands all the way down the backs of the legs. Maybe you can get your hands to go underneath your heels. Push your hips forward and up. Keep that counter spiral going in your legs. Walk your way back up. One at a time, one hand goes higher than the other until you land on your seat. When you land on the seat, push in the seat, pull down. Tuck your chin in and come back up. Arms up to the side. Bend your knees. Drop your feet back together. Standing tall into Dasana like a mountain from the base of the spine and up to the ground. As though at the summit of the mountain. Exhale back down to the base of the spine. Remain solid and unshakable and unmovable in your devotion to the practice. Now from here, come to back in the mat. If you feel comfortable, if you don't have any wrist issues, you can fall into plank. If not, just lower down your knees under table. So if you feel comfortable, hold your breath, lift the heels, bring your hands in front so that you land on your hands, you know. So, and then from here, lower the right knee down, swing your toes up towards your left, and then bring your left knee in behind the right, toes come up to your left, and sit between your heels. Your knees are centered right on top of one another. If you can't get both sides to sit down, you either sit on something or you can lean to your left and bring the left leg out. Still try to keep your knees together on top of one another. The right heel comes to the outside of the hip, left hip. Okay, so depending on where you're at, or if it's too much, just sit with your thighs together, sit on your heels. So whatever form you're in, raise your right leg up, right arm up. Take hold of the elbow, push the elbow up, and send the hand down the back, the middle of the back. Lean back if you like.
down and back. And if you can, you can take your left arm up the back. You have no shoulder mobility issues. Try to get your elbows aligned up one on top of the other. Hold the arm, right arm in place with your head, back of the head. Lift up the arms. Exhale, sink down the shoulders. Feel heavy in the shoulders and the seat. But don't allow the body to drop back down into your hips. Stay very tall and straight and long. If you like, you can tip forward. Bring your belly onto your thigh, perhaps. Your chin hangs over your knee. And you bring the right elbow to the ground. Try to keep your seat on the ground. Back up. From here, switch your legs around if you like. Plant your hands down, press into the outer edge of the feet, lift the hips up. And from here, stay on the same spot. Walk around towards your left. Just spin all the way around until you're facing forward again and lower down again. Otherwise, if that was too much, you just switch your legs around. You can either sit on your feet together with your thighs together or in this pose here, the Fungo Mukhasana pose. Left arm up now. Bring the elbow up high over the head and push it further back behind the head. Push it back hard like you're trying to offer it up from underneath. And if you like, you join the hands together behind the back. Tug on the top hand or the bottom hand so the hands come further down the back. Lift the gaze. Keep the gaze softened though. If your eyes are starting to pop out of the head, you might be going a little bit too far. So just come back to a place where you feel all the sensations. You're reaching a limit to in a conscious, mindful way. And you can stay up. Right, or if you want, you can lean forward. Try not to lift the sit bones up off the ground. Come forward. Belly rests on your thigh. Chin just hanging over the knee. Left elbow down to the ground, or close to the ground. Inhale, come back up. Exhale, release. Good. Shake up the shoulders a little bit. So now, headstand, revisiting that again. Or maybe for the first time if you hadn't did do the first time. So you can always come to a wall if you like, or if you have a chair, you can do it if you're on a chair. So I'll try to demonstrate. Some of us, if I have a chair or a wall. So bring your feet against, close to the chair or the wall, right close. Your elbows are underneath your shoulders. Not too far apart. Don't move your elbows. Make sure you can hold them easily. Then bring your hands forward, interlace your fingers, place the top head on the ground in front of your hands, between your hands. So if you have a chair, you place your foot on the seat. And so you can bring your other leg all the way back. The foot hanging close to your seat. So you try to get to the ground behind you. Keep your knee very bent, your toes flexed so that you stay strong, engage the core, and then eventually you can maybe lift your toes up off the chair. If you're on a wall, your foot is more on the wall like this, your foot's at the height of the hip, and then just pull your toes away from the wall, or bend toes back away from the seat of the chair, or the back of the chair. Right, if you are okay in the pose, you can do whatever expression you like. If you have a lotus, go ahead into your lotus. It makes the mind more one-pointed. And then stay steady. Once you have the steadiness, leave the body alone. Nothing to do, nowhere to go but deeper within. Beyond the body, the mind, and the emotions. If this is too much, you can't, don't feel comfortable at all with coming up very high off the ground,
you can just stay in prayer pose. Forehead on the ground in front of your knees, and just lift your seat up round your back. Imagine trying to get your upper back to look at the wall. Push your belly button right through the lower back, or imagine you are. Your heart right between your shoulder blades. If it feels too much, you have too much pressure on the back of the head, just move your head forward so you're on the top of the head. Right, a little bit longer in your headstand, just as you practice, you get more comfortable with staying in the poses. You have to stay longer, otherwise you don't make any progress. If you just train your body to stay in the pose for a couple of seconds, you won't build up the stamina. And then in 20 years, as Dharmaji says, you'll still be in the same place in your practice. Last 30 seconds here. If you feel comfortable, if your head's on the ground, if you feel comfortable, you can lift your head up off the ground, push into the forearms, and then lift them. Again, according to your abilities, bring your head back down, and then slowly make your way out with control. Your body moving all throughout, like the witness, and then come down into child's pose. Breathe in, breathe out, soften everything. Imagine you're fainting. Then roll your way back up. So sit to one side, bring your legs out in front. And then come onto your back. You might need to scooch the front of the mat a little bit easier, or you have more mat behind you. And then you don't run into a wall or something behind you. And then press into your arms, bring your feet behind your head. If this is not doable for you, you can maybe come against the wall, or you don't have to even have a wall. You can just raise your legs up and sit on your hands, your palms down. So if that's more your level, you can do that. Otherwise, bring your feet behind your head. Try to scoot your shoulders in behind your body so that from front, in front you can't see them. Join your hands together so your elbows come closer and your wrists are together. Bring your hands to your back on the mid-back. So you can lift one leg at a time. All the way up. Take your time to get your leg to stretch way up. So you try to get your toes to the ceiling. And then your other foot comes up. You want to have a straight line of action from your toes all the way down to the chin. If your elbows are not completely behind your back, it might look more like this. This is fine too. Just any inverted pose with your feet higher than the head. And shut your heart higher than the head, so your heart has to work a little bit harder. Again, if you're on the lotus, go ahead. You can always use your hands, keep one back, hand on the back, and then use the other hand. Also, if you have a lotus, try to get your knees up higher than your hips. You have to really push your hips forward. Whether you're on your shoulders, in lotus, your legs up high, straight. If you're right on top of shoulders, you can also bring your hands to your thighs. You will feel the balance once you move. You will feel when you have the balance and be able to release your hands. You have to have your right up, be right on top of your shoulders. Close your mind to all distractions coming in through the ears and the eyes. And all the other sense organs. If you have lotus, now Pindasana. You fold the lotus down onto your front of the body. If you know how to take the full pose, wrap, or you want to try a full pose, you wrap your arms around the outside of the legs and you join your hands just underneath the seat. Your knees on either side of the head. If you don't have a lotus, Just come down with your feet behind your head again in Palasana. If your feet don't come all the way down, support with your hands on the, keep your hands on the back. If you keep pressing into your back and your hips, you can get your hips over your shoulders a little bit, beyond your shoulders towards the head, you might be able to get your feet down. No forcing again, no aggressive movements. Those who like can also slide your legs right in so your thighs are against your chest, knees on either side of the head, on the shoulders, maybe on the ground with some of the shoulders. Getting ready to come into fish pose. If you have a lotus, keep your lotus. Bring your legs down slowly, no big heavy crash landings. So press into your arms. Pull the seat down. If you have a lotus, you press into your elbows, lift your chest up, take your back off the ground, lift your chest up. And then bring the top head to the ground. And from here, you scoot your head in a little bit more by pressing into your forearms. Take hold of your feet, and you have to pull on the feet very hard so that you can get your knees to come down while keeping your elbows down on the ground. Or if you don't have a lotus, you straighten your legs. Your hands are underneath your seat, palms down. Move your shoulders under again. Shoulder blades coming together. And then lift your upper back up off your back up off the ground. Push your chest up, move your elbows in first, and then bring the top head down. Now here, if you can, start to breathe very fast in the nose. If you're feeling strong, raise your legs up 12 inches off the ground. Point your toes, charge your legs. Breathe very fast now. Lower the legs down, relax, bring the head back down, breathe in, breathe out, all fatigue. Now from here, just for fun, roll back into plow pose, push into your arms. And now those of you who can, take hold of your big toes again. We're going to come right up into a bound Navasana. If you can't get your, can't come into this form, and roll onto your back, just roll back and forth. So take your hands back to the knees and sit up. See if you can come into boat pose with your legs bent without touching your feet to the ground first. So do this three times. If you have your toes, hold your breath. Come up and try not to bend your legs. So come back. Two more times. Hold your breath. Come up. And then one more time. Come up. And now from here, either sit here with your flexibility, you might just press your hands underneath the knees. Try to get your chest higher than the knees. Try to sit right on your sit bones. If you're more flexible, you can try to bring your legs right up, cross your arms behind your lower legs and bring your legs up to your forehead. If it's too much, you can separate your feet. Take hold of your ankles or your big toes. Open up your legs. It's a little bit easier to balance here. Lift your chest. And then from here, bring your feet back together. Lower the heels down. Paschimottanasana. Depending on your flexibility, you can hug your legs to your body, push your chest forward towards the knees, and then pour more weight into your legs. If you get your legs straight, don't waste your time. Just come right down. Keep your body connected with your thighs. Keep your attention at the base of the spine. Your attention might attract all the blood in that area. You might feel a sensation of the pulsations of the circulation. circulation of the blood there. Now you can see the energy trying to make its way up. And it said that the energy that lies at the base of the spine, that it reaches, goes all the way up the central circuit channel to the crown. When it reaches the crown, you might experience divine bliss if your 100% of your devotional attention is there. Keep concentrating on that upward motion of the energy to the crown. And a couple more breaths. Keep on visualizing the spine lengthening. Maybe at some point the top of the head will touch the feet. Keep visualizing that. And then release. Come back. Now we're going to come back onto your belly. So looking back the other way now. If you have starting to get tired, you don't have a lot. If you're restricted in the back, you can take hold. Scooch forward so you can take hold of the edge of the mat and pull on the mat. Rest your forearms on the ground, but push down to the forearms, the hips, the thighs, tops of the feet. Lift your chest. Push your chest forward so you don't get a crunching in the lower back. Eventually, you can see if you raise your elbows off the mat, bring your head back. Imagine you're trying to get your head over your seat. If you're more flexible, you can start to walk your hands closer in. One at a time, and coiling bit by bit, keep my lower back long. Bring your feet together like a tail of a snake, stay true to the form of feet. Snake doesn't have any feet. If you're getting more flexible, come on to your fingertips. You have to be close to your body, your hips. And then eventually the whole trunk is off the ground from the top two legs up. You want to open up your legs, keep on lengthening, and then bend your knees, try to bring your feet towards the head. Imagine you squeezing socks behind your knees. Visualize a practice you're trying to attain, even if it's not accessible. Imagine yourself in it. You can only go as far as your imagination with practice. Eventually, the body comes closer and closer. Now, back down. Relax. Breathe in. Breathe out. Both bones. Bring your left arm across the front. Pick the right foot up. Take hold of the heel. And then, if you can, pull on the foot. Try to get your foot up off the ground. Even if you do this, if this is where you're at, then stay there. If you want, you can lift the left leg up. Do this pose, it looks like that, but you're on the ground, so we try to always find the common thread between us. Not all the differences, this is what causes separation and adversity. If you can, take the left foot up, pull on the ankles, and try to get your leg up. Your feet tend to be slippery, so if you hold the feet, you might slip. Take all the ankles, if you want to rock. And you'll come right back onto your thighs. Push through the feet. Push your feet away from you. Good. Or you stay in S form. If you look up, eventually you'll see your toes. Stay a little bit long if you can. If you know other advanced practitioners, you know the overhead hand, you can. So, you'd turn your foot outwards. Take your thumb to the base of the toes, your other fingers around the outside of the foot. Pull the foot up first until the elbow's high on the shoulder, and then pull the elbow forward, and then you take the other foot up the same way. It's easier as you bring your one foot up. Make sure you have your elbow's higher or at the same level as the shoulder so you don't hurt your shoulder, you don't twist your arm in a weird way. Okay, then you come into this variation as well. If you have the shoulder mobility to do so. If you had to rest, you can rest in between if you need to. Just keep trying. Forehead on the ground. Breathe in. On the hands. Breathe out. All right. Last one. Urdhva Dhanurasana. So you can do it from your back and come up, or if you're more flexible, you can do it from standing if you're more advanced. You have the flexibility. So breathe from your back. Feet close to your seat, bring your fingertips on the other side of the head, lift your hips, slide your head back until you're on top of the head. Then turn your hands around. You can stay here with your head on the ground, but eventually hold your breath if you feel comfortable and lift your head up. Lift up off your heels. If it's too much, you do bridge pose or another, or you can do bow pose again. Okay, so if you're trying to do it from standing up, stand up, but I'll show you another option here. If you can do it from your knees, then that might be a better way to go to start. If you do it from your knees and come back up, then you'll have the ability eventually you do with ease, and you'll find it easier when you do it on your feet. So bend the toes under, arms up over the head, and then push your hips forward. Really push into your toes, engage your thighs, arms straight up. Arms stretched out, you'll find the ground a little bit more easily, and then can move your hands back. Okay, so push into your fingertips. Don't wait too long. Really throw your hips forward and see if you can bring yourself up. So if you can do these two poses easily, then this trains you to do it from your feet. So get arms up, stretch, hold the breath, lean back, push in with your toes, and bring your hands down. Okay, so you have to look behind you so you can see the floor. You're trying to do it from your feet, open up your feet, or you can do it against the wall. Go back, find the wall, and work your way down the wall. If you bend your knees a little bit, you might start with the easy Trikonasana, press your hands into your seat, and then take your head back. Once you can see the ground, right hand goes over the head, and then the other hand to raise. So if your feet spread open a little bit more, you're closer to the ground already. Make sure you can see the ground before you take your hands down. Come back up. Press at your fingertips. You have to throw your hips forward a little bit. Push your hips forward. And then release one hand. Bring it to the back of the knee. Push into the back of the knee. Other hand. And then walk your way up. So do it bit by bit. Don't try to do everything all at once. So one more time. Try to come into the pose. Arch the back, bend your knees, be more flexible. Take your head back and find your way down. Or up, depending where you started from. And now lower your head down and relax on your back. Breathe in. Now sit up, arms over the head, or come up, roll to your side, come up to seat it. Baddha Vajrasana. Lean to your right, bring the left leg back. If you can't bring your leg back, just keep it in front. The right leg up. If you can, bring your knee to shoulder, lean back, and pull a foot down across the body so you can take into the left hip crease and the knee down. So you can do this pose. If you can't, take your foot on the leg, or if the knee is way high, really high, you can just bring your foot down. Okay, so it's better to do that than to have the knee way up. If it's sort of close to the ground, you can place a block underneath your knee, and that might help to bring your foot into your lotus more easily. Lean towards the right. Right arm circles around the back. Use your left hand to head. Bring the hand further out in front so you can take your hold of your foot. Or if your foot's on the ground, just take your hand to your thigh like this. left hand to the outside of the knee. Press the back of the fist against the knee. Inhale, push the lower back up and in. Turn to the right. Push the lower back up and in. It's not just the eyes that turn. Visualize the spine rotating around itself. And this might help you to twist more. Start at the twist at the base of the hips. And come back to the front, change sides. So then you'd release the right foot, lean to the left. You can take your left right leg behind if you can do that. Or do the modifications as I showed you before. Left foot comes into the hip. Your knee up first and across and into the hip. Roll the head of the shoulder forward, lean to your left, bring your belly over the left leg, and then come into the pose. Hand underneath the knee, perhaps, if you can, palm down. Bend the chin, find its way over the shoulder. Come down onto your back. Lie down on your back. Make your way down softly. No big heavy thumps on the ground. Always in a mindful and gentle way. And once you're down on the ground, release all tension. Take a deep breath and imagine through this process that all the impurities are being taken away. This is what happens in Shavasana. So all the physical impurities manifest in a feeling of blockage, of tightness, of restriction, whether it's in your muscles, whether it's in your organs, inside of the systems. And so on the inhale, gather up all that tension, all those restrictions, all those feelings of blockages. Exhale, feel them all dissolve. Just melt them all away or drop them out of the body. Feel completely loose, soft, everything just sinking down into the ground heavily. Now, the mental impurities, they come in the form of ignorance. And of thoughts and experiences that we cling to that prevent us from seeing, from considering other perspectives, other experiences, so we can grow. So habits and these thoughts are formed by these impressions of, from the past. Just try bit by bit, always come back to the ethical rules to guide our behavior. So that our comportment is always in a way that doesn't bring harm to others and brings us into a compassionate place. The more compassion we have, the more we can see ourselves in each other, see the divinity in each other, and perhaps that helps us soften all these judgments, all these impressions, and we become more open and receptive to the knowledge that awaits us. And those spiritual impurities are, again, those tendencies that cause us to just stray from those observance, the observance of compassion towards all beings. So making them tension now by saying, by keeping this following thought in your mind and heart, ingrained it in your heart and mind by this sentence. Repeat it to yourself again 3 times mentally. God resides.
resides in all beings. Have you read the divine essence resides in all beings? That is fine too. And when you see that divine essence in all beings, that God in all beings, becomes unthinkable to do harm, to want to do harm to them. So now let's bring that out into the day-to-day life and all our interactions. Prepare to sit again. Do so in a mindful, gentle, and quiet way. Make your way back to seated. And close with Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. And so the peace within send out to all beings everywhere. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Be accepted to the grace of God. All is within. Namaste.